Norbert Mao, the Minister of Justice and Constitutional Affairs, raised the concern today during the ongoing NRM Manifesto Week presentations at the office of the Prime Minister in Kampala. He made it clear that the time is now for citizens to wake up and start demanding for accountability from their leaders.
Citizens, you are not totally helpless. Your political leaders can also take an initiative to ensure that judicial officers who are notoriously corrupt or even incompetent, important for the Ugandan state to demand accountability.
He noted that the Minister of Justice has so far achieved 60% of the manifesto commitments and is very optimistic that by the end of the 5 years' term of President Museveni, a lot more would have been achieved. Some of the notable achievements include reducing corruption in the judiciary, recruiting more judges, partial compensation of war victims, setting of regional judiciary offices, ongoing construction of the Judiciary House, among others.
Manifesto is a 5-year document, but as far as our goals are concerned, we will put ourselves at a modest 60%. Because in the first few years, that is when you lay the foundation. A manifesto, for it to take off, requires initial energy. That's why I'm putting it at 60%.
According to Mao, they are seeking 200 billion shillings this financial year to compensate cattle keepers from Teso and Karamoja sub-region. The judiciary, however, still grapples with the challenge of criminals targeting prosecutors, growing case backlog, limited funds from government, among others.
I'd like to discourage the public from blanket accusation of judges. We have some bad eggs.
The Permanent Secretary of the Judiciary, Pius Bijirimana, has appealed to Service Commission to consider looking into salaries of all civil servants to deal with the salary disparities.
Investments cannot flow in a country that has got a weaker or corrupt judiciary. Therefore, the government should work with the Chief Justice to gradually and affordably improve the working conditions of the judiciary, that is to say salaries, institutional houses, offices, cars. Through inspection and intelligence, however, corruption must be eliminated from the judiciary.
He also warned some sections of the public, especially politicians, to stop demonizing judges and magistrates, especially when some case rulings don't go in their favor. Report compiled by Jaliat Namoya for the news.